Good afternoon, everyone. We will move to the next session, that is Wiki for collaboration and group projects. So there are four technologies that are listed in this, which we have come across either while doing some of the activities or explicitly as sessions. So out of these four technologies, which of these technologies were most difficult for you? Okay, I'll give you 30 seconds for answering this. So apparently Moodle is not so difficult for many of you. I am getting almost an equal distribution between 3 and 4. So regarding screencast, so there are tutorials in YouTube available for how to do screencast, and even the guidelines that we have given are quite self-explanatory. So please make use of that, or else what you can do is post your query in the peer support forum so that others might be able to help you. In this particular session, we will detail about Wiki, which is a tool which you can use for collaboration and specifically for executing or implementing group projects within your courses. So the learning objective for this particular session is, at the end of this session, you'll be participants will be able to identify procedure to follow to join a Wiki in Wiki spaces, perform basic edit tasks in the Wiki, and review a set of TPS questions in Wiki and improve the activities which are not satisfactory. So let's first look at what a Wiki is. In its simplest of definition, Wiki is a web page that anybody can edit. So a difference between a normal web page and a Wiki page lies in the fact that any participant of the Wiki will be able to edit the Wiki page, whereas in a web page, only the author is able to edit the web page and the readers will only be able to view it. So some of the possible uses of Wiki, which in the academic field, is for brainstorming, collection of links, building a portfolio, making lists, to support meetings, and also for group projects. Specifically across this workshop, you will be using Wiki for two things. One is for a group project and another is for building a portfolio. So before actually explaining the Wiki task, we'll do a tour of the Wiki spaces, in specific the Wiki for trial that we have created. So what I'm going to do now is do a screen share. And I am going to log into Wiki. So I am going to explain procedure right from logging in to execution of tasks which are there in Wiki for trial. So first of all, I enter the specific Wiki site that is given to me. So what I am going to do now is enter the HTTP site wikifortrial.wikispaces.com in my browser. So once I press that, you can see that a request for signing in has come in. So what you had to do earlier was give your username, password or join code. So supposing you have never registered for a Wiki, what you have to do is, so supposing I have a new username, let's say abcd@efgh.com, password is some password, I don't have a join in code. So what I do is do a sign in. So you, since I have not given a join code, it asks for these options: forgot your password, create new Wiki spaces account, sign in with open ID. Ideally what you should do is create a new Wiki spaces account with your username and password and then use the join code to join this particular Wiki. So I already have a joining in this particular Wiki. So for the participants, I would request the Wiki facilitators to explain this particular process. You also can use how to, there is a Moodle document for this, how to log in for Wiki for trial. The joining codes have been changed. So I will give you the latest joining codes in a short while. Ultimately what happens is you need to have a Wiki Spaces username and Wiki Spaces account to access the Wiki for trial, the Wiki that we have created for Wiki Spaces. So at this moment, so the Wiki Spaces link is Wiki for trial dot wikispaces dot com. The Wiki for trial document is available in Moodle. So if you actually happen to log into your Moodle, so you see this particular document, how to join Wiki for trial dot docx. You can download this. So please do not use the same joining code. The joining code has changed. So please wait for a while. At the end of this particular session, you will go to the lab. If you have not created your Wiki Spaces account, you have to follow this. At this moment, please do not enter any joining codes or any particular logins to the Wiki at this moment. So for people who are not able to view the Wiki for trial document, it is available in document is available in Moodle. So look at day 3 resources, how to join Wiki for trial. So now let's move to simple edit options in Wiki for what to do for simple edit options. So you can see the options over here, edit, this is for discussion, this is to see the revisions of the particular page, and there are other options like tags, notify, RSS, backlinks, source, print, export, etc. So what you can do is, if you want to create a new page, just go to pages and files, which is on the right hand side of the menu, click the plus button and create the page name. So specifically, if you look at task 1, this has been explained. Go to the pages and files button, which is available in the right hand side of this Wiki page. See screenshot below. So this is the pages and files button. Give the name of the pages, RCID, your first name. I mean, you don't have to include the greater than less than brackets. That is just to identify your RCID and first name. For example, if so I had created something known as RZ001 Jayakrishnan. So I'll just create that particular page right now. So RZ001, this is my RCID, and then I am going to give my page ID. So I'll not use any template as of now, and I'll just say I'll give a small tag as introduction. So what the Wiki does now is give me a page to edit, and it will have the name as RC0001 Jayakrishnan, and the tasks for this are given in this. Enter your details, that means name, college, domain. Enter a table having 3 columns and 4 rows to enter the details of 3 courses that you teach within this domain. Save the Wiki page clicking the save button. So I am going to do this activity. So I am going to write my name, domain I am going to write as educational technology, college is IIT Bombay. Now, what it has asked me is to use tables. So, table is a functionality within the edit page. So, if you happen to edit Word documents or even PowerPoint documents, you would see a separate window for tables. So, similarly, the Wiki editor also has a functionality of inserting tables. You click on the table and it asks you the number of rows and the number of columns. So, here you need to have 3 columns and 4 rows. 3 columns, 4 rows, and in this I have to write course, semester, strength of my class. Let us say course, semester, so I am going to write my course as pedagogy workshop. I am going to write Jan to January 2015 as the semester, because this is the month we are having this workshop. And strength of my class, it's so the total number of registered participants is around 4500. So, I am writing 4500 as my strength of my class. So, you can similarly write the course that you have, the semester in which you are teaching. So, if you are doing it in a even semester, write the semester number. So, typical examples. Computer science 101 or basic computer science will be a first semester course or first and second semester course, and you can write the strength of your class. So, this is a basic editing feature in the inserting a table in this particular Wiki. Now, the next task, okay, I had to save this, so I am going to save it. So, the moment you save it, you can see that a page with the specific ID C, RC0001 Jaikrishnan has been created. These following details are there in it, and this is available as the first revision of this particular page. It is now asking me to go to YouTube and locate one video relevant to one of the courses that you have listed above, copy its link, come back to your page. Add a line at the bottom saying my choice of subject video is given in this link. See this page for seeing an example. So, I have already created this particular page. So, what we will slowly discuss what to do in this particular scenario. See, look at the next task. Go to revisions button seen immediately after discussion button. Compare your latest version of the page with the first version that you had created. So, I am going over here. This is the revisions button. So, you can see the edits that has happened on this particular page across the past 2 weeks. So, I created this particular page at last at 11:45 a.m. on Jan 7th, and somebody has edited it on Jan 18th. So, over the past 11 days, so many edits have happened. So, something that you can do in case your Wiki page has been overwritten by someone is revert to the old version. First, I have to compare. So, I select the first version to compare. So, this is the latest version, and I will go to the initial version and click compare. So, you can see that initially all the new changes come in green highlighted, and whatever were my original, whatever got deleted will come in red. So, what I am going to do now is revert to the last known best page that I had created. So, let me see. So, this is the last edit given by me. I am going to select this and I am going to compare it with this, the latest edit. So, you can see that the details that I had created have all been deleted and new details have been entered. So many people have had this query as what happens if something like this happens. That means you have painfully created a particular content in a wiki page, but somebody has overwritten it right now. So two things. First one, you can protect your page by locking it. And second thing is, you can always revert back to the original version that you had. For participants, please note, I'll give you the joining link at 3 p.m. Kindly listen to the tour of Wiki so that you will be able to understand it. We have had several queries, as in I'm not able to join Wiki, I created a new Wiki, I'm not able to see the tasks. So all those, to the attention of all those participants, please listen to the tour carefully. Take the help of the Wiki facilitators that you have identified and make sure that you do the activities or the assignment which is there now seriously in the Wiki in a clear form. So we were at the point where we have to revert to the original version. So what we do is go to the revisions. So it is taking some time. So the process that you have to do is go to the revisions, click on the last known version, an option will come, revert to the original one. So I am going to the last known version that I have. So this is Jan 7 2015 11:45 a.m. So if I click this, you can see the last known version is available over here, which I have edited, and I can see that there is an option called revert to this version. So what I am going to do now is click on this to revert to this version, saying that I will give a comment, other people edited my wiki, hence. So what happens when you do this is, the page got successfully reverted to the last known configuration which is available over here, which I had created. So you can see that I had created a course with the following workshops, semester, all semesters, strength, I had given all these strengths, and you can see there is a subject video given in this particular link. So there is a link also. Now a quick thing about linking text within your wiki. So you can see that there is a particular text and I have to link an external website to this particular text. So what I'll do is, I'll just go to YouTube and get my videos. So you can see I have the link of the pedagogy workshop videos. So I'm going to copy this. Now for how to create links within your page. So people have written, so just pasting the link is one method, but a more convenient and aesthetically pleasing way of creating a link is, supposing you create a text, the link for the video. So I select the text link, and there is a button called link over here. I click on that and it gives me three options, whether I need to link it to a page within a wiki or a web address or an email address. Since this is an external web address, I'll paste it over here. So you can see the entire YouTube link that I have already created have come to this, and I am going to click new window option in this and create add link. So what has happened is, the text link got hyperlinked to the web page, the YouTube playlist that we have for this pedagogy workshop. So this is how you link external links within a wiki. Other ways to do, if there are internal pages that you have to link, then you have to use the option of wiki pages, give the ID of the pages, and it will automatically create that particular link. So this is a most convenient way of creating web links. And now what I am going to do is, I am going to save it. So these are simple edit functionalities that you do in a wiki, which is sufficient for the group project that you are going to do in the coming session, the lab session. So all you need to know is how to access a page, edit a page, create a table, and insert web links in your own page. So the joining code for this particular wiki will be given in half an hour. So all of you kindly bear with us till 3 o'clock, otherwise it is going to be a messy process. Okay, questions as to where to use wiki and all those things, we are going to see now. So just quickly, just hold on to your queries. Quickly, participants, just see how many of you have assigned group projects at least once in the past year. Share RC coordinators, you share it through the numbers through AVU poll. So it's like, let's say 50% of you have done group projects, you can put in 50%. If it is more, all of you have given 50 given group projects, you can put in 100%. So just take a quick polling within your RC and share the result through AVU chat. What I see is that the number varies from 40 to 100%. So which means that several of you use group projects within your course, and wiki is one specific tool which you can use for group project implementation. And why use wiki? Because there is a need to connect and use various pieces of existing knowledge within a group project. So it may be that you divide the project among students and each of them have to collaborate to make sure a final output comes. Wiki is a perfect tool for that. Refine understanding through discussion and application. Again, for discussion and other applications wherein students may be at different places, then wiki is a useful tool. Peer review, to give and receive feedback. You can use the discussion option within the wiki. And more importantly, what you get is stronger written communication skills at the end of the project. But what you have to be aware is that wiki activities can be messy or chaotic without proper design and supervision, much like a group project. So if you give a group project and tell them to do it, it will not achieve its intended goal. So what you have to do is design the activities carefully, supervise the entire activities that is happening within the group project, maybe a weekly feedback or fortnightly feedback about the group project. So that is how you should monitor the group project, and the same applies to a wiki also. Also, it can be seen that the wiki activities can be complex. So many of you were having problems in linking, in joining the wiki, but they were not complicated enough. You didn't need any extra knowledge about wikis. So simple tutorials like how to join or help from your peers would have been sufficient to do these particular tasks. So just like a group project, these activities could be complex but never complicated. And another feature that you saw just now is that wiki can retrieve older logs. That means what you have done maybe a week ago, you can see it through the revisions, and hence you can resume from any point. So many users would be familiar with the recovery point feature in Microsoft. So you can see that the recovery points have already been defined by the place where you save the particular wiki page. So, supposing I have written a full page on a particular activity and I saved it and I went out and my friend came in and edited it. So, which means that the original article got changed. Now, when I come back and see the changes and some of these are not applicable to me, I can always have the option of reverting back to my version which you already just saw now. So, I reverted to the version that I created on 7th January because I did not want the other changes to come in. So, a good functionality about Wiki is its archival functionality, wherein you can always go and see the wiki logs, the revisions and resume back from any of the previous points. So, what we are just recalled what you did today morning. You looked at the characteristics of good PI and TPS questions and you also did peer review of PI and TPS questions within your remote center. So, what we will do now is you will review TPS questions in your own domain. So, what we are going to do now is we are going to detail out the task 7 in Wiki and the group facilitators have to ensure that you all the members are doing the tasks properly in the Wiki. So, TPS questions in respective domains are being populated in Wiki as we speak. So, the task 7 has the details of these particular TPS questions and what you have to do. What as a remote center what we require is review a minimum of 3 TPS activities in each domain. So, as a remote center in each of the domains given review a minimum of 3 TPS activities. So, you can use the checklist that we had given in the previous session. It can be downloaded from the session slides or I will just post the sessions the review slide after at the end of this session. So, the for the facilitator what you have to do is create a page for your RC as your RC number, RC space your RC ID. So, in this particular page you have to populate the best TPS activities and one additional task that you have to do is supposing there are activities which are not satisfactory or does not conform to the checklist, make sure you improve those activities and populate your wiki page with the best TPS activities, even the refined ones. So, I hope I have made myself clear. So, at this point what I will do is I will take some questions from RCs regarding the use of wiki. So, please note this will be a 15-minute session specifically for wiki activities. So, you can use the hand raise option within AVU. Please listen to the questions and the answers given. So, we have a sharp deadline of 3 o'clock to complete the session because after that you are going to the lab and do the particular activity. So, if your question is same as any of the remote center, the question that is posted by any of the remote center, please take a note, please do not repeat the question. We will stop it at exactly 3 and we are trying to see, make sure that all most of your queries get answered within this session. So, we will first go to Jnanamani College 1203.
Sir, actually we are facing problem to create the grouping.
Okay.
In Wiki.
What is the problem?
Kindly give the details, sir.
To all participants, the query from Jnanamani College is about grouping in Wiki. So, at this moment, grouping needs to happen only within your remote center. You already have participants from domains sitting with you within your remote center. Let's say electrical participants, electronics participants, computer science participants. So, all these are several groups within the remote center. So, for each of these particular domains, we will have specific TPS questions to be sorted within the wiki page. So what I am going to do at 3 o'clock is I will show you the wiki task, task 7. So in terms of grouping, what you have to do is group yourself within the remote center into several domains. So domains as in electrical, electronics, computer science, etc. RC1123 Oriental College of Technology.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, I have a question. We have created a wiki page OCT Bhopal, but okay. I think our page is not linked with the main page of ET. Can you tell me the procedure how to link? I have tried, but it has come back to the same page.
Okay, so first of all, these particular activities are in wiki for trial. So I am hoping that you have created your wiki page in wiki for trial wiki. Okay, so the question from RC1123 is that they have created a page and they are unable to link it to the main wiki page. Okay, so I will just do a screen share at this moment for the benefit of all. Please make sure that you are able to watch it and you are understanding the process. So what I am going to do is, I am going to log into the wiki. So this is the main wiki page that we are talking about. So RC1123, can you tell me the ID of your wiki page?
PED_1123.
Is this your username or wiki page name?
My page name is OCT Bhopal.
So what I am going to do now is, in pages and files, I am going to check for OCT. Okay, so did you see the screen right now, OCT Bhopal?
Yeah.
So it says you have not created a page in this particular wiki.
We have created using ET. While I am logging, two links are there, my OCT Bhopal and the ET repository.
Okay. Clarification to all remote centers, right at the start of the workshop, we had given the link of our course wiki, which is etrepository.wikispaces, to all the remote centers so that you can do a course portfolio at the end of the workshop. Now, wiki for trial is a completely different wiki. So, consider these as two different web pages. Okay, OCT Bhopal, am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so these two are two different web pages, and the ET repository page will be used only towards the end of the workshop. That means for the post workshop activity next week. So it will be used as a course portfolio, which will be described tomorrow. At present, you have to log into wikifortrial.wikispaces.com. wikifortrial.wikispaces.com, where each individual participant has to log in and create their own page. There is no college page in Wiki for Trial. Wiki for Trial is created for participants to practice Wiki, explore Wiki before they finally do the course portfolio assignment. And the procedure for linking the page is the same. You take the HTTP, you copy the HTTP address and paste it in the text where you want to actually link it. Okay, we'll go to the next remote center, IPS Academy, Indore.
But I have two queries. First is on my self query. When I open my wiki portal, so they open to account and username also. After open, access is restricted. You do not have permission to view this page. So what I do for join, I don't have a join code. So please, how to go my join code, receive your retrieve, what's the process, can you give me suggest? And second query is, my colleagues, it's very your submissions properly on my assign, all the task and assignment. But problem is there, they not receive properly and submitted or not in assignment acknowledgement. So how to go to acknowledgement receiving process? Thank you, sir. Carry on.
Yeah. So RZ1039 had two queries. One is that they do not have joining code till now, or with the joining code they are unable to join the wiki. So, and the second question is on assignment submission. They have not received acknowledgement of assignment submission. So please note, I'll answer your question, query number two. Assignment submissions will be handled in Moodle. So if you have submitted assignments for grading, it means that it will be there. So what we'll do is, as a another a second check, maybe by day 3 afternoon, the Wednesday afternoon, we'll share the list of all participants who have submitted assignments from all the centers. We'll be sharing the numbers. So you, as a remote center, you can cross check whether your participants have submitted it or not. For the participants who want to join the wiki for trial right now, so what I'm going to do now is, I'll do a screen share again. So a new wiki joining code has come, MK33. I'll just post it. So this will be posted in Moodle also, MK337NX. So please follow the procedures that we had initially shown. That means log into Wiki Spaces, create an account. After that, to join the wiki, what you have to do is use this particular joining code, MK337NX. So a direct way of joining is, so see this particular link. So we'll post it in chat as well as in Moodle. These two have to be used for joining wiki for trial. That means for the wiki activity that you are going to do now, use these particular joining codes if you have not already joined wiki for trial. If you have already joined wiki for trial, you don't need any joining code. You can directly view all the pages. So I hope RC1039, I have answered both your queries.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now we go to RC1302, Sri Buddha College.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, the question is regarding reverting back, which you have explained sometime before.
Okay.
In the question, actually, like you have created a page on January 7th, and a few people have modified the pages, and that can be found in the revision history.
Yes.
My question is it possible for anybody to revert it back to the original space, or is it the owner only can revert back to the original document?
Okay, good question. I'll just repeat the question that RC1302 has asked. So what he is asking is the reverting back allowed only for the creator of the page, or anybody can have permissions to revert this particular page? So my answer is, it depends upon the format in which you create the page. So supposing you create a new page, what you can do is something called permissions. So there is, so if you create a new page, you will have something called permissions in the right top. So screen share, I'll just do a screen share. So I hope everybody is able to see this. The question is, it only for the user, or is it for everyone? So the moment you create a page, you will see something called permissions, and you can see there are these permission options available for the page. So at this moment, we are looking at a locked page. So that means the organizers of this wiki can change or delete this page, but it can be viewed by anyone with access to the wiki. So as participants, unfortunately, I cannot give you organizer permissions for this wiki, but for the remote center coordinators, we'll give organizer permission in the course portfolio wiki that we are going to describe tomorrow. So within this wiki, at this moment, it is all your playing ground. You can edit, you can revert, and it is editable by all. all the members of the wiki. So RC1302, have I answered your question?
I got it, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Yes, RC1295.
Good morning, sir. The related question regarding the editing option in wiki.
Okay.
Actually, this group, wiki groups, whenever we go in, enter into the domain, then when we write our name and our options, taking subjects, then if anybody by chance removes our name, then it also cannot be reverted back, sir. That is our question.
Yes. The question is, supposing you create a page and you write so many details, and maybe after some time somebody comes and changes it, can you revert it? So the answer is yes, you can revert it. Please make sure that you save whatever you write. So you will have a version of your page saved with the timestamp, date and timestamp. You have to just click that date and time, and it will show you that particular revert screen. You choose the option revert to this version, and it will be reverted back to the original version.
Even in the groups, sir, in the groups where we write our name and
yes, any page. So it is applicable to all pages in this wiki, where you have access and you have access. So it is applicable to all pages within this particular wiki. So we have not separated permissions as of now. So we'll take two more quick questions. DY Patil Institute of 1063.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Actually, question is about the security aspect. So suppose we three staff members are working together on one subject, and we want to assess to give to these three faculty only, and that should not be changed by any student.
Okay.
So limited access, how can be possible to control?
So the quick answer to that is, create a wiki, make these users as organizers. So within this particular wiki, you will not be able to make anyone organizer. It is up to the creator of the wiki. The permission is up to the creator of the wiki. So if you create a new wiki within wiki spaces, then and you add more people to it, you will have the create permissions. And what you have to do is, the three faculty members who are running the course, you can give them organizer access. So the organizers will be able to create and edit the pages. So the question was how to give organizer permissions. The answer is, make a separate wiki, add whoever you want as organizers, the others will be members. So typically your students are members and your colleagues are your organizers, and you can give permissions such that only the organizers are able to edit the particular page. 1147. Kongu Engineering College.
I have one question. Anyone can access the wiki, like anyone can edit or modify the wiki. So how secure is gonna be?
Okay, the question for the other participants, the question posed by 1147 is, how secure is a wiki? So the answer is, it is as secure as you make it to be. So if you have clearly given permissions, if you have clearly delineated the activities, the permissions of each pages, then it will be most secure. And overall, you need a particular joining invite. So I have given you a public join code in wiki spaces. Other methods of joining are giving separate email invites to the participants. So the security of a wiki is what you make of it. So if you create a completely private wiki, it will be totally secure. But as the overhead is, as an organizer or as a creator, you will have to always keep monitoring the wiki and make sure that there is no, disruption or other malicious activities within the wiki. So have I answered your query, 1147?
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. And my other question is, there is one option called we can upload the file. Is there any limitation, like any size limitation for the file uploading?
Yes, in wiki spaces there is a size limitation if you are using. So the wiki spaces is an example of a wiki. There are other applications like what you see, Wikipedia is a wiki, there is a media wiki, all these are wiki applications. So all these are pages, web pages with database. So that is what makes a wiki. So it depends upon your storage space, Wiki Spaces is a private wiki, open wiki, which is available for several users. So they have a restriction of size. If you want an unlimited wiki, it would be better if you create your wiki within your own college. So you can do, your system administrator will be able to install wiki within your college. So in your college server, you will have to install the wiki application. Okay, we will now take two more questions. 1061.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Yes, sir, I have one query. You said that we have to create a page for a remote center in wiki.
Yes.
And you said that we have to populate a TPS activity. And whether we have to populate this TPS activity for the entire participant, or whether we have to segregate them into groups and we have to...
Okay. So this is about the activity that you are going to do in the lab right now. So RC1061 has a specific query about the activity that you are going to do right now. So again, what I am going to do now is a screen share, and I am going to explain the particular activity. If you look at task 7, create your own page. So create your own RC page. So I'll just modify the instructions. So the attention of all participants, this is the task 7. Create your own RC page. Use day 4 AM1 slide number 19 for checklist of TPS activity. Add your details with the link of the page you created in the domain page. So what we have is, so I'll just review. So what you have to do is, there are web pages given below, click on it and you will see a particular TPS activities. I'll just click. So this is an example of a question. So what you have to do is, so in this particular biotechnology domain page, you can see that a course, a topic, and its T phase, P phase and S phase questions are given. What you have to do is, so there are 7 questions in this particular biotechnology page. You have to take any 3. So supposing there are biotechnology participants within your remote center, you have to take any 3 and review it. And you have to use the checklist that has been provided. And at the end of it, create an RC page and populate the best 3 from an individual domain. So if you happen to see civil engineering, so for each of the domains, you can see that TPS questions have been posted. What you have to do is review these questions and finally put the best 3 TPS questions from a particular domain in your own RC page that you create. Okay. So once again, for the benefit of participants, I am going to explain the lab activity, which you have to do from 3:30 onwards. There are specific TPS questions given in the main wiki page. You have to click the domain seeing these TPS questions. There will be more than 5 or 10 questions per domain. So whichever domain is available, you have to rate these questions based on the TPS checklist that we have provided in the earlier slide. Within your RC page, you create an RC page and write the 3 best TPS questions that you think are among these with the question numbers. And this has to be populated by 5 p.m. Today. So you have time from 3:30 to 5 to go and explore the particular wiki activity and sort the TPS questions. So the sorting is what you did already in the previous session. So we are now doing it as a joint activity to come up with the best TPS questions from a given list. So this is the group project. So you are reviewing the TPS questions that are already available to create the best top or the top three TPS questions in a particular domain. The next question is from 1057.
Sir, my question is regarding wiki login. It is asking join code, sir.
Okay, if the question is about joining code, I have just now shared the joining code, new joining code for the wiki for trial. So what you have to do is register yourself in wiki spaces, the joining code that I have given. You can also use the document wiki for how to log in to wiki for trial. So there is a Moodle document explicitly with screenshots on the procedure that you have to follow. So if you already have a wiki spaces account, all you need is this particular joining code or the joining link that we have given. If you do not have a wiki spaces account, what you have to do is create a wiki spaces account and after that click on the HTTP join link that we have given. Then you will automatically join the wiki for trial. Okay, RC1206.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
My question is this. If somebody have edited on my page, I want to revert back the original changes. How it is possible and where is the revert button?
Okay, Bansal College, I hope you paid attention to the screen share that I had done at the start of the session. So if you are having doubt, go to revisions. So there is something called revisions in the wiki page. Go to the specific session or the specific date time stamp of your final edit. Bansal College is asking about the procedure for reverting back. So the procedure is go to revisions, go to your last revision which you think is the correct one, click on the date and time stamp. On the top of it, you will see the changes that has been made, and on the top right corner you will see revert to this version. So that is the revert button. Okay, so go ahead. Pardon?
I want to embed my simulations on wiki page. Tell me the steps how I can embed it.
So embedding or linking your simulations, as in you want your simulations to run in the wiki page. So if it is a GIF or other formats, you just have to give the link. So what you can do is redirect to the web link of the simulation and give the text link within that particular. So we have given you the procedure of how to create web links. Use the same procedure for embedding the link.
Sir, can I access globally my wiki page?
If you have a sign in, you can access it from anywhere. It is worldwide web. Okay, so I'll move to the next center. RC1341.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, you explained clearly about how to create a wiki page. I want explanation about, we want explanation about how to create wiki groups, sir. We already created wiki page individually.
Okay. So, creating a wiki group at this point is out of scope. We will tell you about wiki groups when we deal course portfolio. So this is what you are asking is at a higher level for this particular assignment, and hence we'll definitely deal with creating wiki groups, but we'll deal it with in tomorrow's course portfolio assignment. So the last two questions, this is from RC1085 Nirma University.
Actually, sir, before few minutes you had explained the procedure how to revert back and also change the permission of the page that we have created.
Yes.
But once we have created the page, like suppose TPS constructor page that was created by us, we are not able to locate the permission tab from where to change the permission.
Okay, quick answer to that. In this particular wiki, you all are participants, and participants cannot view the permissions tab because you are not the organizer or creator of the wiki. If you create your own wiki, you will be able to see the permissions tab in your wiki. So this is an exercise on you are using wiki as a student. So we have given only student permissions to all the participants. So we will soon give you a chance to create your own wiki and use all the facilities that are available in the wiki. Okay. So this is going to happen in the next assignment. Okay. So we'll now disperse for tea. So thank you, everyone.